النكاح من سنتي، ما قال النبي هو الصحيح. نكاح مبارك،
مبارك.
نكاح مبارك،
مبارك.
زواج مبارك،
مبارك.
النكاح من سنتي، ما قال النبي هو الصحيح. نكاح مبارك،
مبارك.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Welcome, brothers and sisters, to another episode in the series of Marriage and Divorce with myself and Sheikh Haitham Al-Haddad. Sheikh Haitham is currently residing in the UK and is on the board of the Islamic Sharia Council of Britain and is also the founder of the website www.islam21c.com. Assalamu alaikum,
Sheikh. Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
We want to continue with the discussion on what makes a successful marriage. We started to talk about a few ingredients, and you mentioned that you have some kind of secret formula.
Yeah, bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Alhamdulillah wa salatu wa salamu ala Rasulillah. First of all, let me just go back and remind our viewers about what does a successful marriage mean, how we defined it. We said, and I think I mentioned this number of times, a successful marriage means a marriage where both parties are living together amicably in a way that both of them are trying to please Allah Jalla wa Ala. So the marriage is a mean for them to please Allah Jalla wa Ala, to fulfill their religious and Islamic rights and excelling, not just to fulfill their rights and obligations. This is one. The second thing is they are able to raise righteous children. This is a successful marriage. Now, obviously, the element of love is an ingredient of that, but not necessarily romance. Yeah? Romance can add to it. And that's why if this cannot be achieved, then maybe to have a successful marriage is to end that marriage, in order to have a successful life. Yeah? And we will discuss, inshallah, the issue of divorce. A man came to Umar ibn al-Khattab and he said to him, I don't love my wife. Umar ibn al-Khattab was angry with him. He was about to smack him. Yeah? You cannot mess around with Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu ta'ala anhu. He said, do you think that all these people love their wives? He said, فَإِنَّمَا يَتَعَايَشُ النَّاسُ بِالْإِسْلَامِ وَالْأَحْسَابِ. People live together based on Islam, observing the Islamic rights, Islamic obligations, Islamic practices. And al-ahsab means by lineage. What does that mean? It means that I'm married to this lady. She's from this noble family. She produced my children because of her parents. And because of my children, I need to live with her amicably. Yeah? Similarly, I am the father of her children. She might sacrifice because I'm the father of her children. Another story, yeah, in another story with Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu ta'ala anhu. A lady came to him and said to him, I don't love my husband. He was so angry. He said, if you don't love your husband, just lie and say to him that you love him. And then he warned women. He said, I don't want to know about any woman saying to her husband that she doesn't love him. And this goes back to the issue of wadud. The Prophet ﷺ didn't mention love. He mentioned wood. Yeah? Allah Jalla wa Ala did not mention love. Allah Jalla wa Ala mentioned what? وَمِنْ آيَاتِهِ أَنْ خَلَقَ لَكُمْ مِنْ أَنفُسِكُمْ أَزْوَاجًا لِتَسْكُنُوا إِلَيْهَا وَجَعَلَ بَيْنَكُمْ مَوَدَّةً. First of all, the ayah says, and among the signs of Allah Jalla wa Ala that He created from yourselves, from your souls, azwaj, spouses, that you will find tranquility and contentment with. لِتَسْكُنُوا إِلَيْهَا وَجَعَلَ بَيْنَكُمْ, and He puts between you mawadda. Mawadda means affection and rahmah. Mercy, not necessarily love. Yeah, so I might live with my wife without love. Yeah, I might live with my wife without love. My wife might live with me without love, but with respect, with understanding, with trying to put affection, acting or showing love. This is the secret formula. Yeah? Especially, as I said, from the wife. And as I always say, that if the wife is able to show love, then she is able to manipulate her husband. We always say in the Arabic culture, yeah, that the husband can be just a ring in the finger of his wife. She controls him. Subhanallah, how? A woman, a weak woman, controls her husband easily, yeah, by being a female, a real female, and using her feminine qualities. Part of this, we explained about this previously, but I want to stress on the fact that if there is an argument, part of this would, sister, don't chat back. Don't chat back.
Don't make it a confrontation.
Don't make it confrontational. Just withdraw. Yeah? This is a diplomatic withdraw, a strategic withdraw. Withdraw. Let him calm down. Later on, yeah, in a feminine way, approach him. He will accept your advice or your viewpoint.
And this is actually being the bigger person. And this is also pleasing Allah.
Yes, yes, yes. And I want to warn my brothers and sisters. If you, as married people, if you become confrontational to each other, then the chemistry of your mindset becomes confrontational when it comes to each other, unknowingly. And if you stay like this for a long period of time, then it will be very difficult to rectify it. You need extra effort. It doesn't mean that you can't rectify it, you can rectify it. But you need to remember that now your chemistry of your body, yeah, of your mindset, unknowingly when you see your wife, if there is anything, you become confrontational. Yeah? Or if you see your husband, sister, you become confrontational. Don't reach to that point. Try to solve it before reaching that point. So this is the second one, which is everyone should show love. And we said there are many methods. You can read, you can take courses about how to show love to your spouse. From the husband's side, because we said showing love from both sides, and in particular from the wife. Yeah? And this is the highest priority, or this is the number one need of the husband from his wife, that she is showing him love. Now, showing him love means that she is obedient.
Yes.
It doesn't mean that she's showing love and she's not obedient.
It's not just saying, oh, I love you, and you have no action to back it up.
Yeah. Okay, or even texting him, showing love to him, trying to observe his needs, etc., and she's disobedient. It doesn't work. No, showing love covers being obedient. Wadood, as the Prophet ﷺ said, covers being obedient. So there is no contradiction. It should be understood. Okay? If you think that showing love is different from being obedient, then you misunderstood the point. And you need to refer to what we said about what? The rights of the husband over his wife. Okay? Now, from the husband, what is the secret formula from the husband? See, any woman wants two things from the husband. If the husband is able, or if any man is able to meet two requirements, yeah? Then he will be a successful husband. He should, first of all, should be a protector, a shield, yeah? A source of security for his wife.
This is something I think all females would like.
All females. As we mentioned in one of the episodes, that we run a few surveys. When we have big courses, yeah? 200 women, 200 men, or when we do some of our activities, we ask women, what is priority number one? What is the highest need, your highest need from your husband? And all of them, they say, we need to feel secure. next to our husbands. This is need number what? One. Okay? Security in terms of what? In terms of finance, in terms of general security, and most importantly, in terms of decisions in this life. So the women or wives need to feel that their husbands are taking the right decisions in their life in general. So she becomes convinced that he is a real man.
He is the leader.
He is the leader. And wallahi, this will lift her from a big burden, will release her from that big burden of taking decisions. See, I always say that women can do unbelievable amount of work, provided that the decisions are taken by
husband.
The husband. And sometimes, see again how men can manipulate women. Yeah? He might be busy outside the house, he might be busy in da'wah, he might, yeah? But if he calls her to give her decisions about certain things, the child is ill. The child is ill. Yeah? Now she doesn't know what to do. Take him to the hospital, to the GP, to, in some countries they don't have hospitals, GPs. Yeah? She called him. Now it is a test for him. If he showed her interest in that situation and he directed her and he took the decision. Yeah? And it is likely to be an acceptable decision, then she can do the rest. And she will be happy when he comes back. But if he says to her, well, I don't know, just do it, I'm busy. Just, he's not that ill. I am busy, I told you, darling, that I am busy. What will happen? We'll discuss it after the break.
Inshallah.
Okay.
Brothers and sisters, please return after the break when we will find out the answer to this scenario. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Assalamu alaikum. I'm Ahmed ibn Saifuddin. You're watching Peace TV, the solution for humanity.
Pearls of Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. Abdullah bin Mas'ud, may Allah be pleased with him, narrated that the Prophet, may peace be upon him, said, truthfulness leads to albir, that is, piety, righteousness, and every act of obedience to Allah, and albir leads to paradise, and a man keeps on telling the truth until he becomes a siddiq, that is, a truthful person. Falsehood leads to al-fujur, that is, wickedness, evil doing, etc. And al-fujur leads to the hellfire. And a man keeps on telling lies till he is written as a liar before Allah. Sahih al-Bukhari, Volume 8, Book of Manners, Hadith number 6094.
Most countries of the world ban bullying. They fight it in their schools and universities. A lot of us are being bullied differently every single day. Some come up to us and say, do this, while others say, don't you dare. Some say this is halal, while others say, nope, this is haram. Are you confused? Do you feel lost? Join me in Umdatul Ahkam, where, with the grace of Allah, we will learn the proper knowledge from the Quran and from the Sunnah, which would help stop this kind of bullying.
Join Asim Al-Hakim in Umdatul Ahkam, next on Peace TV.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Welcome again, brothers and sisters, to this discussion between myself and Sheikh Haitham Al-Haddad on the recipe for a successful marriage. Assalamu alaikum, Shaykh.
Wa alaikum salam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
You were just about to enlighten us on the answer to the scenario you gave.
Yes. So, if in the scenario, I'm just mentioning it as an example or a sample of what may happen and how husbands should deal with the situation in order to have successful marriage. So if the wife called her husband and said to him, the child is ill, we don't know what to do, I don't know what to do, and she might be crying. And then he would tell her what's wrong with the child. She might say, well, he has some temperature, etc. Say, come on, this wife, she doesn't know what to do, doesn't take decisions. I am busy now. I am working for her. I want to bring money for her. We have to pay the rent. We have to pay this and that. And she's calling me for something silly. Okay, darling, you do it. You do it. You know that I am busy now. I can't do it. What do you want me to travel all the way to take him to the hospital? I can't do this. Just do it. Please. That's it. Okay, we'll speak to you later. She puts on the phone, and then she will think that this husband is not helping me. This husband is not supporting me. What shall I do if I take the child, if the child becomes ill, if he becomes seriously ill, if the child dies, if. Now all these problems come to her mind. Then she becomes stressed. Another incident like this makes her more stressed. If this becomes the style, after some time, she becomes depressed.
Well, she will not have the confidence in her husband.
And then she will not have confidence in her husband. And then she will come, as I said previously, when the dots are dropped in the
drops in
cup.
The cup.
Yeah? All of a sudden, the cup is
overflowing.
Overflowing or damaged completely, and the water is spilling everywhere. They will come to the Islamic Sharia Council. And the husband will say, I don't know what happened to her. And she said, Sheikh, I can't live with this man. I don't feel secure next to him. He's not giving me time. He's not. And she will start bringing other problems. But the key problem is what? That he's not a protector.
He's not giving her that security, that protection.
He's not giving her that protection, the sense of security, the sense of protection. Yeah? So this is the secret formula. This is number one. Show your wife that you are really what? A protector and a man. Yeah, from all angles, especially decisions. The second thing is show her love, as we said. Yeah?
Make her feel as if she is loved.
She is loved. We said that Allah Jalla wa'ala said, if you feel that your wives become disobedient, then admonish them. And the second one is what? Stay away from them or don't share the bed with them. We said that this sends a very strong message that she is unwanted. Don't ever show your wife that she is unwanted. Yeah? Similarly, we said that to the wife, don't show him that he is unwanted or you are not missing him. Similarly, show your wife this. Yeah? Observing those two pillars, those two secrets, will instill love in the marriage, even if love could not be maintained, but there will be mutual understanding, mutual respect, and they will live with each other amicably. Yeah? And life can continue in a very positive way like this.
And do you think from your experience in the Sharia Council, if this was adhered to, do you think you'd see much fewer problems?
Oh, yes. Yeah. See, in most cases we have in the Sharia Council, the parties might not be able to express themselves correctly or to explain. They might not be able to identify the source of the problem. Yeah? But when I explain to them these things, and they will say, yes, this is the problem. For example, sometimes the wife might complain about her husband. She might mention 10 things about the husband.
But the root
cause of the problem is this, that the man is not a shield, not a protector. He's not acting like a man. الرجال قوامون على النساء. They are in charge. So when you just lead them to identify this, she will say, yes, this is the point.
Mm-hmm.
That I don't feel secure next to him.
And I think on this point of being secure and feeling like the husband is the protector, I think hijab plays a big part in this.
Hijab?
Yeah, the act of, in terms of the husband making sure that she's covered for him and kind of not letting her being shown to the world.
Ah, yes, yes, from this angle, that when he is looking after her from this angle, he needs to explain to her that, see, part of this hijab is just to make sure that you are secure, that men will not target you, yeah, that you are not vulnerable, that you are not an easy target or an easy victim.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, this is definitely. I want to say something else about this protection and sense of security. See, sometimes husbands, it is funny, in many cases, a couple comes and the wife is complaining about the husband. And it is clear that this complaint has not reached to the level of divorce, but she is complaining. And the husband is shocked. And sometimes he laughs. He laughs. I say, why are you laughing? I understand why he's laughing. He said, I never expected it to be like this. Come on. He said, darling, come on. I always tell those husbands that you are taking certain things lightly, but she is not taking them lightly. And if you continue like this, yeah, the marriage will go through many other difficulties and it might end up in a breakdown.
So he, for example, he probably doesn't understand what is important to his wife.
Yes, yes. The sense of security, for example. There are some men who lose their jobs and then they find another job. Sometimes they don't find a job, etc. Yeah? Now, the wife wants to feel that she's stable. She has children to look after. If she feels that the husband sometimes brings money and sometimes he might say no, or she feels that he lost his job, now she feels embarrassed that she will ask him for money, then she will start feeling insecure. Financially what? Insecure. Yeah? And the husband said, don't worry, I told you not to worry. Don't keep saying, don't worry, don't worry, don't worry. The reality is she will be worried.
Words are not going to change anything.
Yes. Okay? So don't put her into a situation where she feels insecure. Although you know the situation and you claim that you have control over the situation.
Mm-hmm.
No, don't do this. Okay? This will lead to many consequences. This is again part of what? Feeling insecure next to him. Again, feeling insecure against him is when his parents sometimes might abuse her. Okay? And he doesn't say anything. The key thing is she will feel that he's not siding with her. He's not protecting her. He doesn't love her. Yeah? So that's why we always say in this scenario, yeah? Although we always say to them, sister, don't expect that your husband will chat back to his mother. Don't expect this. Yeah? This is his mother. She might say, but this is unfair. This is... We know unfair, etc. Some parents are abusing their rights or abusing their position. Are doing haram.
Sometimes you need to sacrifice a little bit to see the bigger picture.
Yes, this is one element, as we said previously, that the philosophy, the Islamic philosophy, is to sacrifice a little bit in order to attain or to win, yeah, the bigger picture. But from the other side, we always advise men to speak to their wife separately, to show them that they are still loving them, they have not been influenced by what the parents said, to show them sense of security, yeah, and to comfort them.
To reinforce.
To reinforce, yeah, the values or the love or the feelings they had for them. And this is very important. And this will minimize the impact of the so-called abuse by the parents to the wife.
Mm. Yeah. And it shows that in the Sharia, it's a complete way of life. And we have everything. Even though, like you said, this is not following everything strictly and rigidly, but at least we have the framework to work it in.
Subhanallah. Without tashaddud fa dawt, yeah.
Jazakallah khair, Shaykh.
Barakallah fi.
Brothers and sisters, please come back to us in the next episode where we shall continue the discussion on what is a successful marriage and how do we actually attain the successful marriage. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. مبارك مبارك زواج مبارك مبارك النكاح من سنتي ما قال النبي هو الصحيح نكاح مبارك مبارك there is joy there is happiness